This is Evangelist George McTyre of the Word of God Ministry, and I'd like to thank you for taking the time to view this clip on a subject that I know is not going to sit well with a lot of people, but I believe that it is necessary. In fact, I know it's necessary because of the condition that we find this nation in and how we got in it. Got in the condition we're in today. I hopefully can get this done in this clip, but if not, then there will be a part two. And the subject that I want to be addressing is essentially the difference, if you will, but I'm going to point out crucial, life-altering differences between Republicans and Democrats as it pertains to the Word of God. And I want to use a couple of scriptures here. The first scripture, I stay in this scripture quite a few times. If you've listened to several of the other clips I have out, I use this scripture as a start. Hosea 4:6, it says, "My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee. That thou shalt be no priest to me, seeing that thou hast forgotten the law of thy God, I will also forget thy children." So right away, God says the people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Now, as I said, I want to give you these differences as it pertains to Democrats and the Republicans and the foundations, if you will, that both parties are built on. Using another scripture, this one is found in Proverbs chapter number 1 and verse number 7. It says, "The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instruction." Look at that. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. Hosea 4:6 says the people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. So what can we deduce from these two scriptures? Well, the first thing right off the bat is the people that are destroyed for a lack of knowledge, they have a lack of knowledge because they have no fear of the Lord. In other words, that word fear does not mean being terrified of, even though it could be that way, but that fear means without acknowledging or seeking God's input into any area of your life or whatever situation you may be going through, or in this case, what the nation may be going through. And here is the problem as it pertains to Christians and the parties that they support. I don't care what your race is. I don't care if you are a senior citizen. I don't care if you are a woman or a man. I don't care about any particular groups or whatever it is that you belong to. It all boils down to the same thing, and that is, we are being destroyed because of a lack of knowledge, and that lack of knowledge is because there is no fear of the Lord or the consequences of going against what God says. Having said that, here is the problem with the Democrats. If you will look at the foundations on which the Democratic Party is built on, that foundation is built on no fear of the Lord. They don't care about what God has to say about anything. They will whatever God says is right, they have a problem with it. Whatever God says is wrong, the Democratic Party supports it. And here is where the major difference in a lot of areas, but I'm going to address one area right now in this short time span that I have, and that is the area of abortion. Now, people don't know because they have not been taught, because a lot of preachers, sad to say, in churches, especially in the black community, do not have a full understanding of what abortion is about, other than the fact of what they want to believe, and that is it's a woman's right to choose, which I don't necessarily have a problem with that, but I would dare say that if more women were educated on exactly what abortion is and what it is doing, then, especially if you happen to be a Christian woman, then there would be far less abortions. I assure you of that, especially when it comes down to Christian women. But here is the main problem. God, you know, he looks at our situation based on what he says is right and wrong. And when we choose, after we have been informed that something that we are doing is wrong, and we refuse to change our ways, and God knows that we have been told that, that is when you suffer the greatest. Why? Because you have basically openly defied God. See, when you didn't know something was wrong, then there's less of a backlash or less problem that you will face as compared to those that know better, because they have been told, but they have chosen to reject. If you look at that scripture I read, Hosea 4 and 6, what did he say? He said, because thou hast rejected knowledge. He said, the people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Then he turns around and say, because thou hast rejected knowledge. What did he say? He said, I will also reject thee. Once you've been told, you may not like what you've heard, but that's beyond the point. The fact is, once you have heard something and you continue to do it, God says, hey, you done rejected knowledge, because this is what's being provided to you on this clip. Now, here is the thing about the Democratic Party. As I said, the Democratic Party, basically its main support, in other words, the groups that support it are the women's groups who want to keep abortion legal. You got the gay community, which is also an abomination to God. Actually, I'm going to put it this way. I'm going to label them in the order of the more serious first. The first one, quite frankly, is rejection of God. That's the first one. When somebody just openly rejects God and anything he has to say, period, that's the first major problem right there. But as you go down the list, all of these other things basically fall into that rejection of God anyway. The one right behind openly rejecting God and believing that there is no God, or whatever you want to call it, the Bible says the fool has said in his heart that there is no God. But right behind rejection of God is abortion. After abortion comes homosexuality, or the gay movement, and so forth. Then you go down further, and you get into the defining of what we call separation of church and state, where we tend to get the idea that we'll keep God over here and the state here, and that the state runs on its thing, it pays no attention to God. And as far as God is concerned, keep him over there in the church. We won't deal with him out here in the public arena. That's the next step down. So the thing, God has priorities. But the thing I want you to see is this. The foundation of the Democratic Party. There is a scripture that asks the question, can two walk together except they be agreed? And actually, the answer is no. You cannot walk together with somebody unless both of you are on the same path, going in the same direction at the same time and at the same pace. That's the only way you can walk together. So the point then becomes for the Christian, and that is this. If you have a party whose foundation is, quite frankly, of the devil, then why are you supporting that party? Now, you may not have known the situation, but you know it now. If you're viewing this clip, or if you're listening to the audio of what I'm saying, you know it now. You, as a Christian, should not be joined to anything that goes against the God that you are supposed to be, or you claim to be believing in. What I'm trying to do here is trying to see if I can find that scripture. But anyway, the point is this. While neither political party is perfect, while each has their flaws or has some faults, by far the Democratic Party is so far away from God, it is pathetic. If you will look at the fact that you've ever heard the expression that the journey, any journey that you take begins with the first step. In other words, if you're in a wrong place and you want to get out of the wrong place, that scripture I was talking about, can two walk together except they be agreed, is Amos chapter number 3 and verse number 3. If you are on a path that's leading you to destruction, or you're going in the wrong direction, the first thing you need to do is basically change directions. And since there's two parties, and the Republican Party, though not perfect, is not as bad as the Democratic Party, then the best thing for you to do is to leave the Democratic Party and support a party that at least is trying to do those things that are right in the sight of God. But you see, we, especially in the black community, and I'm going to get into this in part two. I told you I was probably going to have to run over. We in the black community have a serious problem, because while other races will switch between Democratic and Republican, the black community is Democrat or nothing. And that's where one of our biggest problems lies. Go into clip number 2 and we will continue from there.